Hello out there, Erik Haaland with David Walters Yachts. I'm here today with Gypsy in 1997 Hylas 46. This is hull number 11. She's in really, really nice condition, and she's all set in turnkey, ready to go to the Bahamas this fall. Come see her in Annapolis, Maryland before it's too late, because you don't want to miss out on this one. Let's take a tour. Starting our tour of Gypsy on board, we'll start here at the bow. You can see we have two anchors here, primary and backup, both fully rigged and ready to go. Primary here is on the Maxwell windlass. See, we have a new Genoa furler. This is a furler 404S from Selden. Back at you can see the Hylas trademark stainless steel striker plate up here on the bow. Now, this whole portion of the deck has been recored recently, so it's solid as a rock, and the striker plate was also removed and reinstalled using through bolts instead of normal tapping screws. So it is ready to go. See here we have the anchor locker, nice and clean and dry. The windlass there, our primary and secondary rods are separated. We see the recently applied new non-skid and all grip on the deck is in fantastic condition, ready to go. Staysail here is hank on. It's in a bag on deck. It's easy to remove and store when not needed, and you can remove the inner forestay, and then you can turn her into a sloop rig, so it's easy to tack here on the Chesapeake Bay and turn into an offshore rig with a cutter at a moment's notice, no problem. We have all the opening deck hatches here. You can see the lenses are all in fantastic condition. There's no crazing going on. The stainless steel is in great shape. The varnish is in great shape. Everything gleams really nicely. I love the aluminum tow rail, easy to lash things down to. You see we have the all new running rigging here. All the lines have been updated. We have a Kemp mast with new standing rigging. We have a carbon fiber whisker pull. You see the new radar up there, all that's looking really good. Over on starboard, you can see the Achilles dinghy is all set and ready to go. We have a Suzuki outboard motor on the back of it. This is a high pressure forward dinghy, so it's light and easy to store on deck or on the transom. Moving around, we can see we had the Dodger and Bimini, both of which are in fantastic condition. Lifeline gates. We have Lumar winches. Cockpit's nicely appointed with teak seating and a teak graded floor. Instrumentation forward on the companionway. More instrumentation here in the nav pods. Swinging around, we can see the propane locker. There's two bottles in there. We have port and starboard 100 watt light leaf solar panels. Now these are flexible and folded down currently. The ray vents are in fantastic condition. On the aft deck, there's a windlass life raft. We have an outboard dinghy motor lift, throw ring, outboard motor mount, more storage here in the lazarette. We have teak steps for the stern platform here, along with another locker and a swim ladder. On the port side, another lazarette, magma barbecue grill, life sling, GPS antennas, another solar panel. And then when the standing rigging was recently replaced, they added a hydraulic backstay adjuster. This is great to get a bit more performance out of the rig. We have a stack pack traditional mainsail, so the performance of Gypsy is just excellent. The shore power has been upgraded to smart plugs, so they're really easy to connect your shore power connections. We have a teak and stainless steel boarding gate that can move from the port side to the starboard side. And then entering the cockpit, you can see here up forward, we have one of three remote mics for the VHF radio. We have Rainmarine ST60 Plus instrumentation. We have a main sheet, outhaul, and van controls here. Engine control panel, engine has 3,659 hours on it. Main sheet winch. We have our lighting and cockpit controls here, windlass controls. And then at the binnacle, we have a Ritchie compass, Raymarine Axiom display, and Raymarine autopilot control. Really nicely pointed and ready to go. The main living area on the Hylas 46 is the saloon, just at the base of the companionway. We can see that this is a large area with a U-shaped dinette to the port side. A lot of natural light. We have a lowering dinette table with a removable leaf, so it makes into a smaller table. This middle portion here pulled out. Just beneath, there is a sliding cushion that can also double as an ottoman for the starboard side settee. This starboard side settee also pulls out about another foot, so you can make it into a sea berth. There's storage beneath and behind both settees. Further on starboard, we have multiple storage lockers, bookshelf, reading lamps, white and red overhead courtesy lights. Aft is the galley and master stateroom. Port aft, we have a nav station with pass-through head. And again, here back on the port side, we have two cabinets, white and red courtesy lights, 12-volt helifan. Of course, we have the mast here, which is a keel step. As we move forward, we enter the guest cabin. And the guest cabin is a Pullman berth off to the port side with a double-sized bed with four drawers beneath, three cabinets above, and a shelf. We have a grab rail. There are two stainless steel opening port lights in this forward cabin on the port side, and we have a third one here on starboard. Behind the entry door, we have a settee, another storage cabinet. And then on the forward starboard side, there's a hanging locker, and the back side of the forward head door has a nice full-length mirror. Moving into the forward head, we can see that it's really nicely appointed in a large space. Off the starboard, we have four mirrors with built-in cabinets behind. A large vanity, which is made of Wally stone with faucet. And we also have the two vents here for the forward water tanks. Storage and through-hole valve access beneath. Up forward, we can see a teak seat here with a shower curtain. There are storage cabinets forward and on the sides. Jabsco manual flush head. We have a teak grate here with built-in sump pump for water evacuation. We also have the switch here for the windlass. The storage up here is plentiful. In this locker, we have storage here. This is full of supplies, but this locker extends forward under here, which is under the anchor locker. And then to the port side, we have more storage shelves. Good spot for cleaners. And we have some more deck rigging storage. We have bosun's chair, various other items. Turn around, we see a towel rack. Again, another view of the sink here and vanity. Quick look inside. See here we have the three-way valve for the forward holding tank, various point fittings. Engine access on the Hylas 46 is excellent, thanks to these large opening doors in the front and on the sides. Starting at the front, we open the stairs. You see we have the Yamar 4JH2 TE engine. This engine has just about 4,000 hours on it and is in excellent condition. You see we have two alternators. We have Gruner engine driven refrigeration. We have coolant tank, seawater strainer, clean engine mounts, clean oil pan, Raycor fuel filter with vacuum gauge. Everything looks to be nicely in order here. We even have a 12-volt and 110-volt outlet. If you have any tools needed while working on the engine. Moving around to the starboard side, see we have the fuel filter here for the phaser generator, which is back there. It's the starboard side of the Yamaha engine. Again, very clean, looking good. Oil filter, fuel pump, all that looking to be in a nice shape. We have the air conditioning pump right there. Again, the engine pan looks very clean. Moving to the next compartment aft, so we get a better look at the phaser generator here. And this is a premium generator. It's got a beta diesel engine on it. This is a, I believe it's a 5 or 5.5 kilowatt genset. Everything here looks to be in really nice shape. Very little to no corrosion at all on anything in here. It looks fantastic. We can see the dripless shaft seal down there and the transmission coupling. There's normally a corrosion on them because of this standard steel. They're not coated with anything. All that looks to be in really nice shape. All the insulation's in good shape. We have a service light in here for new maintenance. Everything looks really good. Moving around to the port side, we have another large door here. Now all these doors lift off the hinges as well, so you could take them off and put them somewhere when you're working on the engine. See, there's the compressor for refrigeration, the engine alternator with a starter there. Everything looks really good. There's the exhaust elbow looks really clean. All the hoses are nice and pliable. I don't see any cracks in anything. It looks really nice again. Nice and clean engine mounts and engine bed. Moving into the aft head, we come to this large door here. And this large door, we have the water here. The water heater here is 6 gallons. It's in nice condition. We have the breathers here for the coolant systems for the engine and generator. All of them look to be in a really nice shape. Let me see the generator end of the phaser here. And we have components for the Grunert refrigeration system here. Again, everything is very clean, easy to access. It's in very, very good condition, been very well maintained. One of the hallmarks of the Hylas 46 design, which is also something that's really well known in a lot of the Hylas's out there, is the passageway galley. Thanks to the center cockpit, we get this expansive galley that for a 46 footer is massive. And if you're planning on living aboard, you want a galley like this. So we've got plenty of storage here. We have trash, drawers, we have propane range right here, 3 large burners. We have 2 refrigeration units, and these are Grunert seawater engine-driven units with holding plates, and they're really nice. These are also 110-volt powered when you're tied to shore power. See, the freezer works. We've got ice, really good insulation. We even have some cookies down there, and the owners are very well-known for their great cookies here on the dock, so maybe you'll get some if you come look at the boat. Again, more storage drawers here, cabinetry. We have all of our plates and fiddles here, not going anywhere. Knife storage. We have an opening port light here for ventilation. Turning around, we've got a little spice rack, an olive oil rack they've got set up. And more storage here, microwave. Folds in just like that. Then we have a large and very deep double stainless steel basin sink. We have fresh water and seawater foot pumps, along with a sprayer and mixer right there. Really nice setup. See here we have the controls for the Rain Man water maker, which is a recent installation on this boat. After the saloon on the port side, we have the nav station. Now this is a traditional forward-facing nav station with a large chart table. We have all of our electrical switches here. Entertainment and navigation electronics. House battery charger monitor. Backup GPS receiver. And lots of storage and drawers for flashlights and our tools. We have our main battery disconnects down here. And of course, the world-renowned Hylas wiring, award-winning. This is absolutely fantastic. Nicely laid out and organized. Everything's in fantastic condition. Proceeding after the galley, we enter the owner's berth. Now this has the centerline queen size bed, which is a hallmark of this design. We have bookshelves straight aft with reading lamps and 2 opening port lights. As well, there's an opening hatch on the deck, and two other opening port lights, port and starboard, along with fixed port lights, port and starboard. There's a mirror on the door that leads to the head. On the port side, we have multiple storage drawers and cabinets, along with a power station. And on the starboard side, we have a built-in settee here, again with multiple storage drawers. See, this is a nice large area with great headroom. And then on the forward bulkhead, we have here built-in wardrobe. There's an air conditioner that's situated specifically for this cabin. Finally, we come to the aft head. Now this has the pass-through option to the nav station, so it makes the shower area a great spot to drop your foul weather gear when coming off of a watch. We have a Wally stone sink and countertop, just like in the forward head. We have a teak grate with sump pump, shower curtain. We have another mirror on this bulkhead here. Opening port light and more storage behind the mirrors here, as well as a large storage cabinet in the shower. I'd like to thank you for tuning in for this video of Gypsy, the 1997 Hylas 46, hull number 11. She's in fantastic condition. She's all ready to go, fully turnkey. She can take you to the Bahamas this winter. So give me a call at 410-279-3027 or shoot me an email, Eric, E-R-I-K, at davidwaltersyachts.com.